Hello and welcome to the course CS353 Grid Computing. We are in the module 4 and this is the third lecture of this module. Continued from the last lecture, this is the second lecture on MyProxy, which is a credential repository system built for grid computing environment. As I have already told you, we are following this paper. An online credential repository for grid MyProxy. So I again request you to go to this paper and read it properly to get the material presented in this slide. So this talk is based upon MyProxy credential repository system. So this is our syllabus of module 2, which we will not discuss anything about this because we have discussed everything about this in lecture 1 of module 4. So when you want to use MyProxy, then there will be two basic steps involved in this. There are two basic steps we have to follow before we are using the MyProxy credential repository system. The first step is delegation of a proxy credential to the repository. So what does it mean? Delegation means we can say we can pass our information or we can pass our credentials, the user ID and the passphrase to the repository. The repository will store all those things for us for later use. And then the second step is retrieving the credential from the repository. So that means after some time or after we log into the grid portal, then we need those credential and that credential will be retrieved from the repository. That is the only two steps involved in credential repository system or MyProxy credential repository system. So let us discuss every steps one by one. In the first step, as you can see, there will be a MyProxy credential repository present. Then we have to execute a function called MyProxy underscore init. This is the function which will be used to delegate our proxy credential to this MyProxy credential repository. So I am executing this function, then by proxy credential, which is user ID and the passphrase, will be transferred to this credential. So let us read it step by step. The MyProxy credential repository system consists of a repository server, okay, and a set of client tool that can be used to delegate to and retrieve credential from the repository. So the credential repository system actually consists of a server as well as some client tools that will do two things. One, he has to delegate or pass the credential to the repository server, and also they will help us retrieving the credential from the repository later at some point of time. An user would start by using MyProxy init client program along with their permanent credential to connect to the repository, and delegate a set of proxy credential to the server along with the authentication information and retrieval restrictions. So the client will use the MyProxy int program and they will pass the credential of himself to this repository, and they will apply some restriction to it. There are several restrictions can be applied on user and the password, like how much day it will be valid, who can access those credentials, and there will be other algorithms to or other client programs to delete, and how many time you can use that particular proxy credentials. So everything restriction you can apply on that user and passphrase. The authentication information in this process consists of a user's identity and a passphrase to be used to authenticate any later retrieval operation. So before you apply your user ID and passphrase to this, you need to be authenticated. You need to be authenticated user to use this proxy server. So that's why the authentication information in this process consists of a user ID. So you need a user ID and your passphrase to authenticate yourself. Both the user identity and passphrase are chosen by the user, As you have already remembered that we will have a long-term authentication username and password which was generated by a CA, and that need to be converted into a temporary or the short-term credential. So whenever you are choosing a short-term credential or the username and password, that should be chosen by the user itself. Okay, that helps us to remember our username and password for further uses. The credentials delegated to the repository normally have a lifetime of a week. So this is normal, but you can set your restrictions. You can set your restrictions like I want this password to be stay there for 2 days or 3 days or some hours maybe, but the default one will be 1 week. The user can also at any point use MyProxy destroy client program to destroy any credential they previously delegated to this repository. So finally, if your work has been over and you don't want to use the grid services later on, or you, for any case, if you want to delete your credential that was stored in the server, you can use the client program that is called MyProxy destroy client program. And when you execute this program, then automatically your proxy credential get deleted from your proxy server or MyProxy server. This is how the delegation of proxy credential to the repository will occur. Now that your credentials are already present in the MyProxy server, now anytime you can use it while you are using the grid services. So let us see the second step. The second step is retrieving the credential from the repository. So when you need to retrieve the credential, you need the retrieval whenever you need to access the grid services. So during the access of the grid services, the you need to provide your credential to the grid portal. Then grid portal in your turn will ask the proxy server or the MyProxy server about your credentials and check whether you are an authenticated user or not. And using that user ID and password or passphrase, he will allocate the services and monitor your services during the execution process or during the program execution process. So let us understand this. At a later time, the user or a service acting on behalf of the user, so whenever you want to access your credential, so either you access the credential or a service acting on behalf of the user, as I have already discussed in grid portal or grid computing concept, you need to pass your user ID and password to some portals. The portal will be acting as a delegate for you, who will use your user ID and password to give services from different service provider. That's why, so whoever acting as a delegate for you, he will use MyProxy get delegation program to contact the server and request a delegation of the user's credential. So either that portal or you, anybody can use this program, MyProxy get delegation program. This is a client program too. To execute, after execution of this program, you will be able to contact the proxy credential repository and you get the credentials which was previously delegated by the user. Okay, so during that process also, the user must supply the same user identity and the passphrase that they provided when initially delegation and the credential to the server. So initially, whatever user ID and passphrase we have created or we have given to delegate in the or to pass the information in the proxy credential, that we need to specify to the grid portal itself. After verifying this information and checking any restrictions that the user presented with the delegation, the repository will in turn delegate a proxy credential back to the user or the service. So he will check the information, he will check the restriction that you have made during your registration process or delegation process, then he will give back the proxy credential to the user itself or the services who requests them. So this is the two steps involved. Now let us see how the entire execution process carried on. Means how the where is the portal present, where the user present, how the things are get executed in the next line. So this is like this. So this is your MyProxy repository where you have already stored your user ID and credentials, or user ID and your passphrase. This was maintained by MyProxy repository. You are the user who uses a web browser to access the grid services. The web browser in turn will contact the web portal or a portal. The portal will assign you, or he act on your behalf. He will be the he will be acting as a user on your behalf, and he will access your credential from the MyProxy repository, because he has to assign all the services to you, and every services or every resources may authenticate separately as the resources are present distributed throughout the grid. So he need your credentials to allot the services to you. Okay, so the first step is the first step we have already discussed. The first step, not this step one. So this is I am written as the first step to use MyProxy system with a portal is to delegate a proxy credential to the repository. This was already discussed here, this part. So when you have using the MyProxy INIT program, you have already registered yourself over here. It means you have delegated your user ID and passphrase to the MyProxy server. Fine. So there, this is the first step. After completing that, this will be happen. Then at a potentially different time and place, the user would connect to the grid portal. So after some time, we can connect our grid portal or web portal using a web browser. By using a web browser, we will connect the grid portal and supply the authentication information. You can read it as web browser, or you can read it as grid portal. Okay, so both are same. So grid portal. So you'll connect with the grid portal using a web browser and supply the authentication information given earlier to the repository through a web form or similar interface. So in the web browser, you will able to see a GUI where you can provide your credentials. That credentials has already been registered in MyProxy repository, as we have already discussed. Then those credentials will be taken by your web portal or the grid portal. Then the user might also specify MyProxy repository for the portal to use, assuming it's configured to use more than once. So after giving it, he can specify the MyProxy repository, means which repository which repository they have stored that user ID and password. And he knows, the user knows, that the grid portal will use that information for multiple purposes, or use that particular authenticated information for multiple uses. Okay, this is the first step. Then second step is the portal or the grid portal. The portal connect to the MyProxy repository using a MyProxy get delegation program. So this is another program. MyProxy get delegation program authenticates itself using its own grid credential, presents the authentication information, user identity and passphrase as provided by the user, and the request a proxy credential for the user. So web portal is someone, or the grid portal is someone who has their user ID and password too. So they will authenticate itself using its own grid credential. So whatever grid credential it have, so he will send that. After authentication, he will pass the user's identity and passphrase. Okay, we have already provided the user identity and passphrase to the web portal. That he need to pass to get the user ID and password from here. Right, so after getting the user identity and password provided by the user, and a request a proxy credential for the user, so he will generate a proxy credential which has a very limited lifetime. Okay, and we have already set how much time or how much time it can be validated. We have already give some restrictions over here. That restriction should be followed by the grid portal. Okay, after everything is done, the repository then, after verifying all the presented information, to delegate a proxy credential for the user back to the portal. Then the one proxy credential will be given back to the web portal or the grid portal, and the grid portal now uses this to access the resources for us or for me or for the user. So after that, what will happen? The portal then can securely access the grid, using the standard grid application as the user normally would. At this point, the user would direct the portal through the existing connection with the web browser. So after everything is done, the user can now access the resources through the grid portal itself and give direction to the grid portal what to do and what not to do. The operation of logging out of the portal deletes the user delegated credential on the portal. If a user forgets to log off, then the credential will expire at the lifetime specified when the requested from the MyProxy server. This lifetime is normally on the order of a few hours. So what does it mean? The meaning is when the operation of logging out of the portal means whenever the user has working on a particular server and he want to log out. When he logged out, then automatically the content of means whatever information we have provided to the web portal, it also gets logged out from the portal itself or the grid portal itself. So that's why it's written that the credential on the portal, the grid portal deletes the credential, delegated credential on the portal. So the portal is also get deleted. Fine. So the maximum lifetime of a credential delegated to the repository is set by policy of the repository server, but default to 1 week. So as I have already told you that the default is for one week it will store those informations and later he has to delete it. To see a complete picture, I have drawn a complete picture of the entire application. You can view it as like this. So this is your web portal, or we can say this is your grid portal. You are here, you are the user, and you can access the grid portal through a browser, web browser. Before you access any grid portal services, you need to register your user ID or passphrase to this particular MyProxy repository. So the MyProxy repository will store your user ID and password. Then during the login, you use the web browser and provide your user ID and password, which was registered over here. That user ID and password is given to the grid portal. Now grid portal uses his credential to log into the MyProxy repository and ask for the user ID password, which was registered or not. Then that user ID and password he will get, and he confirms that this user is a registered user. Then after this process overs, the communication starts between web browser and the grid portal. Means the user and the grid portal through web browser. The user asks for the resources they want to access. Then the grid portal goes to the grid resources. There may be multiple resources asked by the user to use. Then the grid portal will register this user to use those resources. The registration may be multiple times will be done, but the grid portal will not ask multiple times the user ID and password because the user ID and password is already there in the grid portal. Then when you log out, then the grid portal, all the user credential will be deleted from the grid portal. If you forget to log out itself, then also after some time, the time limit you have already set, after some time those things are get deleted. So this is the complete lookup of the entire process, and this is how the MyProxy repository works. That's all for the today's class. Thank you.